Hello students, today we will continue with functional dependency. I hope all of you have referred our previous session. Actually, in the previous session we have studied a concept called functional dependency, which is actually related with the relational schema. So a functional dependency from x to y means if x repeats, y also will be repeated in a table. That is the meaning of functional dependency. That is, if y is dependent on x, that means if x repeats, y also will be repeated. And we have already seen in the previous session. Then in the previous class, we have seen a concept called closure of functional dependency. That is, the set of all functional dependencies which can be derived from an already defined set of dependencies. So for a relational schema, you might be given a set of functional dependencies already defined, but we can infer or we can derive a set of functional dependencies from already defined one. So this total set is called the closure of a functional dependency. So to derive a set of functional dependencies, we have to use some set of rules. In today's class, we will study these rules which are used to derive functional dependencies. So here we will study Armstrong's axioms of functional dependency. Armstrong's axioms are 6 rules which we are using to derive functional dependency. So Armstrong's axioms are used to define closure of a set of functional dependencies. So as I told, Armstrong's axioms are rules or axioms to find the closure of a set of functional dependency. First rule is reflexivity rule. If x is a set of attributes and y is a subset or same as x, then x to y always exist. That is the first rule. That is, from x to y, if there is a dependency exist, and if y is a subset of x, then we can say this functional dependency will always exist. One example is given here: SSN and name to SSN. This is a functional dependency defined. Here SSN is a subset of the SSN and name. So such a functional dependency will be always true. So the meaning is, if SSN and name repeats, SSN will be repeated. So we know that it's always true. Then the second rule is augmentation rule. The rule says, if x to y exist and gamma is a set of attributes, then gamma x to gamma y also will exist. So if a functional dependency from x to y is already defined and we are augmenting another set of attributes in both sides, gamma is another set of attributes which we are augmenting or appending in both sides, then we can define a new functional dependency, gamma x to gamma y. Example is shown. If a dependency SSN to name exists, it's already defined, then we are augmenting a set of attributes in both sides. Salary and address are appended in both sides. So we can define a functional dependency SSN salary address to name salary address. That is augmentation rule. Now the third rule is transitivity rule. If x to y exist and y to z exist, then we can define a dependency from x to z. So example we can see, if SSN to name, it's already defined, and a dependency from name to address is already defined. So we can define a new functional dependency from x to z, that is from SSN to address. Next rule is union rule. If x to y exist and x to z exist, these two dependencies are already defined, then you can define a new dependency from x to yz. So the union of RHS, right hand side attributes, are defined here. From x to yz always exist. Example is shown. If SSN to name and SSN to license number exist, we can define a new dependency from SSN to name comma license number. So here we have written the union of right hand side of both dependencies. Now the fifth rule is decomposition rule. It is actually the reverse of union rule. If x to yz exist, that is if x to yz is already defined, then we can define two functional dependencies from it, from x to y and from x to z. Example is shown. From SSN to name and salary, already defined. Then from this dependency, you can define a new functional dependency from SSN to name and SSN to salary. Then last axiom is pseudo transitivity rule. It is similar to transitivity rule. That's why it is known as pseudo transitivity rule. If x to y exist and yz to w also exist, then we can define a new functional dependency from xz to w. So these are the six Armstrong's rules or Armstrong's axiom which are used to define closure of a functional dependency. So we will see example. This is an example to find the closure of a set of functional dependencies using Armstrong's axioms. Such questions are frequently asked for university examination. So you have to try these examples. The question is, consider a schema R with such attributes with a set of functional dependencies. These are the given functional dependencies from A to B, A to C, CG to H, CG to I and B to H. These are the functional dependencies already defined. So we have to find the closure of this set of functional dependencies. We know closure of functional dependency means already defined dependencies along with that the set of dependencies which we can derive from it. So we can see whether we can define or whether we can derive new dependencies from the existing one. So in the first step, A to B, a dependency from A to B and B to H are already given. A to B and B to H are already defined in the question. So when applying transitivity rule, we can write, if A to B and B to H exist, we can write a dependency from A to H. So that is a derived functional dependency applying transitivity rule. Again, in the second step, CG to H, it's already given in the question. CG to I, that is also given in the question. It's already defined. Then, when applying union rule, we can define a dependency from CG to HI. So this is again a derived functional dependency. Then in the third step, A to C already exist, already given in the question. So I am augmenting G in both sides. So AG to CG, I am appending G in both sides by applying augmentation rule. Then CG to I is already given. So we can apply transitivity rule here, AG to CG, CG to I. Combining these two dependencies, we can write AG to I exist. Then A to B already given, A to C already given. So when applying union rule, A to BC already we can derive. So this is how closure of a set of functional dependencies are to be derived. So finally, we will get a closure set represented by F plus, that is already given functional dependencies A to B, A to C, CG to H, CG to I, B to H. These are the already defined dependencies. Along with this, we will write our obtained dependencies also A to H, CG to HI, Then third step we have obtained AG to I, then fourth step we have obtained A to BC. So this is a final closure set. So this is how a closure set of functional dependency is to be derived. Now another concept is closure of attribute set. So the definition is, if X is a set of attributes, the set of all attributes functionally determined by X under a set of functional dependencies is called closure of X. It's denoted by X plus. So here we are defining a closure of attribute. So this may also be asked in the examination. We will see one example. Consider the previous example. Find the closure of attribute set AG. So here we are defining closure of attribute. Closure of attribute means it's a set of all attributes which are functionally dependent on this particular attribute. So here in this question, we have to find the closure of AG. That is, we have to find the set of all attributes which are functionally dependent on AG. That is closure of attribute. So these are the dependencies already given in the previous question. Using these dependencies, we will see what are the attributes dependent on AG. So AG to A, we can define a dependency from AG to A by applying reflexivity rule. That is, A is a subset of AG. So always AG to A exists. A to B is already given. So we can write a dependency AG to B. Then AG to A applying reflexivity, A to C is already given. So we can define a dependency from AG to C. This is by applying transitivity rule. Then A to C is already given in the question. AG to CG. I am augmenting G in both sides. So I have written AG to CG. Then CG to H is already given. Now by combining these two dependencies, AG to CG and CG to H, I have written AG to H, applying transitivity rule. Then AG to CG we have already obtained in the last step. CG to I is already given in the question. Then we can apply transitivity rule and write a dependency from AG to I. So here we have obtained in four steps the set of all attributes which are functionally dependent on AG. So here the closure of AG can be written as A is dependent on AG, B is dependent on AG. In the first step we have obtained B is dependent on AG. Second step we have obtained C is dependent on AG. Then third step we have obtained H is dependent on AG. G will be obviously dependent on AG, because just like AG to A, AG to G also will exist according to reflexivity rule. Then in the last step, I is dependent on AG. So these are the set of attributes which are functionally dependent on AG, which is known as the closure of AG. So that is the concept of closure of attribute set. Now the next concept is equivalence of functional dependencies. You may ask to find whether two set of functional dependencies are equivalent. So the definition is given. For two sets of functional dependencies F and G, if the closure of F is equivalent to closure of G, we can say F and G are equivalent. So if you have given a question to find whether two functional dependency set are equivalent, you have to find the closure of each one. Then compare the closure set we have obtained. If the closure of F and G are the same, we can say F and G are equivalent functional dependencies. So if all the functional dependencies in F can be inferred from G, G is said to be covers F. If all functional dependencies in G can be inferred from F, F covers G. If both F and G covers each other, F is equivalent to G. So that is the concept of equivalence of functional dependencies. So in this session we have studied two main topics. First one was closure of a set of functional dependency. Second one is closure of attribute set. So that's all about today's session. All of you go through the example and study this concept clearly. In the next session we will be doing more examples. Thank you.